All right, first of all, we're going to do this. Everybody need to put a smile on their face before we get started. And then if I start to feel what I felt up here this morning, and I like to have D-Rock coming off the stage. Randy like to come out in the choir loft. If that's what it's going to take, then I'm going to bring all y'all up here preaching the choir loft. All right? We want the Spirit of God that was in here this morning and back in here tonight. Never left, to be honest with you. We just got invited to be a part of this great service. All right? Everybody knows this song, so I'm going to get you to stand with me right now. Everybody, come on, stand up with me. You're going to help me sing this song, and everybody knows it. And y'all just let the Lord lead you, okay?
Come on, let's get the devil out of here.
Took back what it stole from me. When I went, she came and stayed.
main line. Tell him what you want. Jesus on the main line. Tell him what you want. Jesus on the main line. Tell him what you want. You can call him and tell him what you want.
Oh,
God redeemed him completely when he walked through heaven's gates.
Thank you. when the rain pours,
even when the floods start rising,
even when the storm comes, I am washed by the water.
Yeah.
preachers and they're ashamed. I've been born again, without a doubt I know I'm saved.
Thank you.
that I've been hurt.
Oh,
My daddy always shared with me about how much love he felt from the members of this church. And me personally, I don't continue to go somewhere that I don't feel loved. You know? And that's a defect of mine. I should never let another personality run me away from something I love. But my daddy always expressed that the people from this church just loved him and he was amazed by it. And he kept coming back and he kept coming back. I made him do it on his own. I made him come on his own, you know. I made him bug people to get a ride and start reaching out. There was a lot of things that I wanted from my daddy. There was a lot of things I wanted for him, you know. And I just couldn't do it for him. And I loved him. And there was a lot of things that we missed out on a good part of life together. We missed out on a good part. But I got a second chance to be with my daddy in church and see the good side of my daddy. And he had a smile on his face. When I seen him, he had a smile on his face. And he wasn't thinking about nothing else. He knew I was okay, and he knew that y'all loved him. And I want to thank you all from the bottom of my heart very much for loving my daddy. That was important.
Oh, just been set free. My chains were broken. I've been born again. Oh, the wonder and mercy of him. Oh, mercy walked in and defeated my pain. All to stand. God save
and then tells the story of Jesus being on the cross, and that thief that decided to ask for him to be with him, to remember him whenever he was in paradise that day. And he looked at him and said, "You will surely be with me in paradise."
I am the thief.
In paradise.
somebody to draw closer to Him. And for somebody to know Him intimately. For somebody who may have stepped away or fallen away from Him for a moment and to step back. For somebody to be called to Christ for the first time. See, Brother Ricky didn't live the most wonderful life in the world. He drove for the Almagros. That's pretty nice. Meet Derek Allman. That's what Ricky would have told me. He didn't live the greatest and grandest life in the world. And when he left this world, he left to go to the greatest and grandest place in the world. He didn't leave behind anything worth staying for. All I want is to be with Jesus. Hold your loved ones close and you tell them you love them right now. You don't wait until they're gone and it's too late. Don't hear me. Because every one of us are going to have to take that step over that river. Brother Ricky didn't have a lot. But I don't believe for one second that we're not all here tonight for one purpose that God had intended. That very date, at that very moment, Brother Ricky was going to close his eyes in this life and open them up, standing before Jesus Christ, looking in His eyes. And it would bring us all here together tonight for this purpose. He may not have had a lot of life, a lot of money, and a lot of riches, or a lot of things in this world. But in the end, He left out the richest one of us all. He left out knowing the Lord Jesus Christ is His personal Lord and Savior. And He's starting His eternity. Thank you so much from the bottom of our hearts. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Because God has proven Himself once again. All week we've been saying, not going to worry about a thing because God has got this. And He has the whole time. He's got this. All things work together for the good of those who are called and love Him are called according to His purpose. Do they not? His promises come true again and again and again and again and again. His word will never return unto Him void, is what the Bible says. So as long as we hold on to that and we believe that, and I don't know if all of you know, but Derek asked me to marry him on Valentine's Day, and I said yes. But we're starting our home. We're starting our new life together on the foundation. The foundation is established within both of us, and we're going to trust Him. And we're going to hold Him. And we're going to keep Him as close as we can. Because there's nothing more I want out of this life, being close to Jesus, with the man that'll be my husband, than to stand before Him myself face to face. Nothing greater than that. Thank you, thank you, thank you again.
Give me 5 more minutes. 5 more minutes. There's going to be a sound, just like he was just playing. Whoever's doing that. A sound that some of us will not be able to distinguish. The Bible says a trumpet. A trumpet will sound. And the Bible said the dead in Christ will rise first. And all those who are left and remain will be called up and meet Him in the air. That's biblical. All these graves out here that know Jesus Christ, that soul's not there, y'all. It's an empty tomb. It was a place that the soul had
a rental.
Thank you. And the least front of them. Now they're in heaven waiting on us in a permanent form. But here's the question. Now I know everyone. Brother, I've got to say it, okay? You're just going to have to forgive me. But dog, if you and Derek don't look a lot alike. I'm sorry, but you do, y'all. That's Derek's uncle right here in the pink shirt. Good to have you, and we appreciate y'all coming out and being a part of this. Ms. Wood, it's good to have you back with us tonight. Thank you for coming out and being a part of this. And we're so glad that we were able to help Derek and Emma. But I got to ask a question. Kenny and Wendy's here, and Little Man, we thank y'all for being here. Y'all, and I'm going around, if I don't stop, I'll miss somebody. So let me stop before I miss somebody. It's so good to have everybody here tonight. We thank you for giving us an opportunity to practice in front of you, but we had no clue that this was going to come up like it did. None whatsoever. I wonder if God did. God did. But let me say this. Chris and I issued an invitation this past Thanksgiving. We've been praying about this, and we've heard Nicole say this over and again, over and again, over and again. We need to do more outreach for people in the holidays. So what Church and I did, we opened up our doors at the house and said, if you're going to spend Thanksgiving by yourself, please come to my house. Guess who showed up? If Brother Rick calls Lonnie and Lonnie don't answer, Rick's calling me.
Then the boss gets on me.
And then he goes, is somebody coming to get me? Yes, sir. Somebody's on the way. Let me find out what's going on. And all I had to do was hit the button and to speed dial with Lonnie. And the first thing Lonnie answered, I know. I missed his call. I missed his call. But y'all just don't know the words that I had to hear him talk about. The things that he shared with me that I've shared tomorrow night that I found to be funny. But also, y'all gotta know this. Though he was short and small in stature, he was a man's man.
Yeah.
He was huge.
He was a couple of boys.
Yeah. And some of the stuff, some of the stories he's told me about the road, being on the road with the Allman Brothers, just fascinated me.
But I will say this. About 4 weeks ago, we were coming here. He told me, he said, you know, I do a lot in my lifetime. He said, but Derek is two times a better man than I am. And I said, oh, Richard, I said, you're a good man. He said, but I'm going to tell you something for life. He said, Derek turned out to be a way better man than I ever been. He said, I love that boy, and I'm proud of him. One thing about Derek, you can always remember your dad loves you.
Maybe. Well, I'll never forget that night that Derek came in. Jerry said he had somebody coming that could play a guitar good. He didn't say pretty good, he said good. When we stuck Derek on the guitar and he started playing, I'm going, that ain't good. That's real good. And then we started watching Derek grow from that point on. He's got in the Word of God, he's got his life right with Jesus. That's what really matters to us. We're going to be like glue. We're going to be stuck by his side. He's going to think we're genuine pets. We love your cubs. We really do. And thank you for letting us have a part of his life.
When he first started coming playing, y'all hear how he plays now? He wasn't going to do that. He said, it's rock. And that's what I'm used to playing. I'm like, that's what I want you to play. Because see, this is the way I look at it. That's what God put in there. So therefore, he already knew what was going to come out like when he came out. Oh, I'm sure glad he got over that.
Now, y'all at first Derek was real shy about what he was doing up here. But did y'all see him this morning? I thought he was going to knock me down. I thought I was about to get up here and get a Holy Ghost revival started back. Y'all, sometimes I think what we need to do is just bring everybody up here, sit them down in the choir, let them feel and see what we feel and see. I think they would take a run.
If they felt and saw what we felt, they'd be out there anyway because they'd be running.
Yeah.
Some would be running around, some would be running out, but they'd be running.
All right. Folks, if you're here tonight and you do not know Jesus Christ as your personal Lord and Savior, you just heard a series of songs that we love to do, we love to minister to people with. But we most important part is this. We don't want to leave this house if you don't know Christ. We don't want to leave this house if you don't know Christ. Beyond a shadow of a doubt, you know where you're going to spend eternity. Everybody say amen.
Amen.
Beyond a shadow of a doubt. Your last breath here will be your first breath in heaven, correct?
Amen.
Praise God. And that means that I'll see you one day. If the Lord decides to take me home tomorrow, I'm not going anywhere.
I'm not going anywhere.
But if God's ready for me, I'm ready to serve. Okay? I got to say this real quick. Decided to finally tie the knot and let me sign that piece of paper. Can that all I do just sign the paper? Don't let me say nothing.
That's not gonna happen. Johnny can't not say nothing. Derek said he's paying for full service.
Son, I'll go ahead and tell you this. Me and Trisha, the night that we opened our house to you, you stayed with us for that short long time. We were glad to know that God sent another man in our life that we could call a son. And we still call you son. And so like AJ and you go, and everybody else that's ever come into our life, they see something. They see something. And I'm glad to know that I can be a part of y'all's life. Always depend on me. Because I depend on you. And just let me love you. That's all I'm asking. And when this old kid real quick start to cry, I'm just going to look at it. But that's the compassion that I'm trying to teach. Folks, we've got to have that compassion to be able to minister to one another. So the day I stand before you, you and Lord to announce your husband and wife, I'll do it something like this. Hello! I'll still sign the license, but I'm telling you, it's going to be a mess. Okay? So just be prepared. We love you. We love you, Eddie. We're glad you brought him into our life. Thank you for that. Folks, y'all be back tomorrow night at 6 o'clock. We come to celebrate the life of Brother Rick. We're going to come and just celebrate a life that's just been very pleasant to us. He'd always sit right there where Brother Russell sits, and he'd always have the kindest words to me every Sunday morning. I step down to the pulpit, he'd reach his hand out, and he said, it's always good to be in a house where people love me. Thank you for loving Mr. Richard Adams.